Dear students, in the previous class we are discussing about partnership, partners, firm, partnership deed, capitals, drawings, etc. These are only for 2 months questions. So now let us take up some examples. These are very important. About 30% of the questions will be occurred in the unit 1. So example number 1, I have already sent through WhatsApp all the 37 questions. Out of that, I will solve only few of them because of limit of time in the this online class. Example 1, go to the example number 1. I will just read. A, B and C are business partners with capitals of 4,000, 5,000 and 6,000 respectively, and the total profit is 4,500. You have to divide among them according to their investments. Very simple example solution. So the investment of A, the partners A, B and C is 4,000, 5,000, 6,000, or you can divide all the numbers by 1,000. There is no change in value. If you divide or multiply by the same number to all the numbers, all the capitals, there is no change in the original numbers. So in this case, the investment is 4,000, 5,000, 6,000, or 4,500, 6. The ratio is like this. Total is 15,000 or 15. Now A's share is, see, in this 4,000, 5,000, 6,000 out of 15,000, A's capital is 4,000. So ratio becomes 4,000 divided by 15,000 or 4/5, both are same. 4 by 15, you can take 4 by 15 or you can take 4,000 by 15,000. The profit is 4,500. So this becomes, this ratio is 4/5 into 4,500. If you cancel this, so cancel zeros and all, you get rupees 1,200. Similarly, B's share. What is the B's investment? B's investment is 5,000. So, out of 15,000, B's share is 5,000. So, 5,000 divided by 15,000 into the profit is 4,500. That is for 1,500. So, only simplification. So, C's share is 6,000 out of 15,000, C's share is 6,000. So 6,000 divided by 15,000 into 4,500, that is equal to 1,800. So if you add all these 1,200, 1,500 and 1,800, that gives you 4,800. So this is the distribution of the dividing the profits according to their investments. Let us go to the next example. Just example 2 is, divide the profit of 36,000 between A and B in the ratio of 1/4 and 3/4. The ratio is already given. You need not take up the ratio at all. You can convert the numbers. Directly they have given the ratio, 1/4 and 3/4. Out of total, 1/4 by the A is contribution, and the 3/4 is the ratio or the contribution of B. Now total profit is 36,000. So out of 4, 1. So out of 36,000. So A's share of profit equal to, A's share of profit equal to 1/4 into 36,000, that is equal to 9,000. Similarly, B's share of profit equal to 3/4 into 36,000, that is equal to 27,000. So this one method. Another you can do that is once you get the S share, that is 9,000, you can deduct out of the total, you will get again 27,000. That also you can do that. So the both are the same. These two are the two examples. The next example I have not. You have to solve it. Try to solve it home. Otherwise, I will take up in the next class. So just I will give the idea of how to solve that. I will first of all I read the example. The total profit of a partnership firm amounted to 7,350 in a year, out of which A received rupees 1,400 more than B. See, this is the clue for you. More than B, and B received rupees 350 more than C. So comparison is there. Find the A's share and also find profit sharing ratio of A, B and C. So what you have to do is, so A is dependent on B here. See the question here. A received 14,000 more than B. You don't know the B, but A's share of profit is 14,000 more. He earns 14,000 more or extra rupees than B. B receives 350 more than C. So you have to take up here. C is clear. C is not dependent anywhere. B, A is dependent on B, B is dependent on C, C is independent. So you have to take it as the total profit equal to, the total profit is already, it is given 7,350. Let X be the profit of C, because the C is independent. Then you can have to take the B's profit. How the B's profit? So what is written there? So B is received 350 more than C. So the share of C is X. Whenever you take X, then it should be X plus 350 is the share of B's profit. Similarly, what is A's profit? A's profit is the profit of B plus 1400. What is the profit of B? B's profit is 350 plus X. So 350 plus 1400 is the A's profit. Or in other words, I can say that A's profit equal to X plus 1750. Now already got all those. See, C's profit is X, B's profit is X plus 350, and A's profit is X plus 1750. So now all the ratios are given. Now the contribution is given, the total profit is given. Total, what is the total profit here? Total profit is 7,350 means 7,350 is the total profit. Total profit equal to A's profit plus B's profit plus C's profit. So left side you have to take the total profit. So total profit equal to A's profit plus B's profit, C plus profit. So that is equal to 7,350 equal to X plus A's profit. What is X? A's profit is X plus 1750 and B's profit is X plus 350 and C's profit is X. And simplify the this equation. You get equation and simplify this and you get the values of X. That is the answer. Then hence you find the ratio, the profits of profit ratios of sharing A, B and C. This is the clue for you. Try at home. Let us stop here. Thank you.